Dear students, professionals, and lifelong learners, dear Peter, welcome to our week 5 recap. Time flies, and this week we had a lot of interesting discussions regarding previous topics, but we mostly dealt with resource shortage.
Hello everyone, hello Theo. It is indeed really nice to see that resource shortage is a topic that is close to students' hearts. We certainly hope that our lectures were inspiring for you, as we consider resource shortage quite an important issue.
Well, Peter, looking at all the contributions that we have had from our students, I think this target was achieved. So let's begin with some really interesting examples from our discussion forum. Sajid, from India, stresses the issue of oil use all over the world. I agree with you, Sajid. Oil is indeed one of the most excessively exploited finite resources of our planet. He also poses the following questions. Why is that happening? And also, if we move towards renewable energy, what will happen to the financial stability of the world? Will we be moving into another recession due to low income of the GCC countries? Who are the drivers of the world economy? What is your view on this, Peter?
Well, transforming a society that is built on oil in its economy, technology, policy, and infrastructure is not an easy thing to do. It involves not only changes at the producer end, but also at the consumer end, and at every stage in between. However, if the oil-producing countries ignore the need for change, they indeed risk to undermine their future, as Mark Carney, the governor of the Bank of England, argued last year.
Thank you for this answer, Peter. I hope this is more food for thought for you to discuss this topic even further. Another interesting post comes from Germany, as Dominic questions some of the answers given at the urban farming questions. Interesting points, Dominic, and hopefully your feedback will spark a constructive conversation between the course staff and the participants.
Well, like the one about the CU 2030 project in Utrecht, here at the Netherlands.
Exactly. I was talking about it with Mr. or Mrs. Van Forst and Dunk. And it's great that you noticed, actually. For those of you who are not familiar with this project, it is about the sustainable redevelopment and modernization of the whole central station area of the city of Utrecht. What did you think of that discussion?
Well, I think all of the lecturers, including myself, of course, enjoy seeing such kind of engaging conversations. The CU 2030 project development combines many of the topics that we have been discussing in this MOOC. So there were really some interesting and really good examples of sustainable urban development given by all of you.
Thank you, Peter.
So these were some really valuable insights, while we also had very interesting results from the practical assignment of week 5.
That's right. And what do you think about the uploaded pictures and the comments that we have received?
Well, I really like that people are seeing all sorts of inefficient resource use. For example, the picture on the left, posted by Laura Roosberg from Spain, which shows inefficient use of water resources. She says the rainwater should be reused instead of discharged, which is a very good point, as we know that Spain is a country that can suffer from long dry periods. The urban environment offers plenty of opportunities for rainwater harvesting, and this should be a very good solution to this problem.
That's true. This actually reminds me of the picture posted by Anne, showing us the empty roofs of an industrial area. I think this is a very good illustration of opportunities, not just for rainwater harvesting, but also for solar energy installations, green roofs, and so on. What about this illegal waste dumping picture uploaded by Francesco Mascotti from Rome?
Yes, shocking, Theo. It is great to note that some people found indirect, inefficient resource uses. When waste is dumped, many opportunities for recycling and reuse are lost. Instead of serving as an environmental resource, dumped waste becomes an environmental hazard. There were also a lot of discussions about this issue in our forum, since there were plenty of pictures showing tons of dumped waste. Emilia and Unais, thank you for your inputs, and you make a good point about the separate at source solution for waste disposal.
This picture on the right is also interesting. Gerard, who comes from the Philippines, shared it with us, as he stresses that urban farming can be a great way to make resource use more efficient.
Thank you for your picture, Gerard. Indeed, urban farming is a great example of reuse of resources, such as rainwater and organic waste. in order to produce more food for densely populated areas. At the same time, old and vacant buildings within cities can be used as a resource for urban farmers.
Really good point, Peter. And great contributions from our participants for yet one more week. However, we noticed there was still little activity on the 100x100 challenge.
Yes, and that is too bad, Theo, because in the end, there will be a small assignment competition between all teams about the content of the 100x100 challenges together.
Well, this does sound like a challenge. So the more you're involved now, the better prepared you are for the final 100x100 assignment. So, Peter, week 6 will be about digitization and geodata. What should our participants expect to hear and learn this week?
Well, this week we will talk about the need for comparable city data, the concept of smart cities and smart citizens, the increasing role of ICT in the modern transport system, the different mapping methods and GIS-supported spatial analysis, as well as why 3D geoinformation is important for sustainable urban development.
Thank you, Peter. I am already looking forward to start, and I hope it is the same for all of you. Keep up the good work with the practical assignments and use your creativity to win the 100x100 challenge. There will be a prize for that. Finally, we would like to thank you for your patience while we were dealing with the technical issues of the map app. Android users will receive an email with instructions very soon, and hopefully there will be no more struggles. One last thing, if you cannot see the pictures that you have uploaded for your previous assignments anymore, please do upload them one more time and everything will be in place.
Please do not hesitate to contact us for any feedback, remark or problem. We are always open to your suggestions as we want to keep improving our course for an even better experience.
So, Peter, everyone, that was our week 5 recap.
And we're all anticipating seeing your responses for the challenges of week 6.
So, thank you for watching.
And enjoy the coming lectures.